Hey y'all, it's Hans. Welcome back. So we got a big review for you today. We've got the Nocpix Ace H50R. So we're going to be talking about the H50R, the H50. We got the L35 right here. We got the S60R right here. We're going to be talking about all of them, but this is the official review of the H50R and H50 right now. But first, if you're looking to purchase a brand new optic and you're considering doing that from Outdoor Legacy, the uniqueness about this channel is not only can you see all the reviews, all these different brands, all these different models, see the optics, see through the optics and see what the picture quality looks like, learn about them, find out if they're right for you. You can also call me directly. So if you want to buy from Outdoor Legacy and you need to know if one of these optics is going to work for you or maybe something else, another brand, another model is going to be better, it helps to have that one-on-one phone conversation. And you can do so 877-350-1818. All the products at Outdoor Legacy are online at outdoorlegacygear.com. Be glad to talk to you and help you decide on which optic is best for you. All right, before we jump in the review of the Ace H50 and the H50R, let's talk about the differences between the Nocpix Ace line of scopes. These are the Aces. This is the L35. This is the little brother. When you see L, that means it's 384 resolution. So this is the Nocpix Ace L35. It does not have a laser rangefinder. It's just the 384 resolution with ocular magnification, large 2560 by 2560 display screen, $2,500. Fantastic scope at under $3,000, especially for you predator hunters out there. Then we have, this is the H50R, which is basically the same as the H50. So you have the H50, which is $4,299. It's a 640 resolution, 3 power to 24 power digital magnification, and 3 to 9 ocularly. We'll be talking about that in depth here. This is the H50R. So the way that you know the difference is, it's got that little laser rangefinder module at the top of the objective lens. So the H50R, when you see the R, that means it has a rangefinder. That one is $54.99. Again, without the laser rangefinder, $42.99. Let's bring out the big boy. This is the S60R. So S stands for 1280 resolution. The H stands for 640. S stands for 1280. This does have the built-in laser rangefinder. Price on this is right at $7,000. We're going to be doing a full review of the L35 and of the S60R shortly after this H50R review. Okay, we got the H50R right here. I mentioned briefly the differences. Let me talk about them again, and then we'll jump into the specs of the H50 and the H50R. So again, the H50 640 resolution without a laser rangefinder. That is $42.99. This is the H50R. Everything else about these optics are the same, except the H50R has a laser rangefinder. The regular H50 does not. The H50 is $42.99. H50R is $54.99. And again, the only difference is the laser rangefinder. The H50 still has the large 2560 by 2560 display screen. This it does have ocular magnification as well. But let's jump right into the specs of the H50 and the H50R. We'll dive right deep into it, and you'll be able to see some thermal video at the same time. All right, the specs on the H50 and the H50R. Talk about it. We'll mention it again. The H50 is $42.99. That does not have the laser rangefinder. The H50R does have the laser rangefinder. Price on that $54.99. All the rest of this is going to be the specs are going to be exactly the same on both of these. So resolution on both of them, 640 by 512 thermal sensor resolution, minus 15 millikelvin sensitivity sensor rating. That's a mouthful right there. 12 micron digital magnification, 3x to 24x, but it also has ocular magnification that goes from 3x to 9x. So we'll talk a little bit more about ocular magnification because that's a very big, important benefit that you really need to know about. The field of view is 46.2 feet at 100 yards. The detection range, this is how the manufacturers measure it. It's a human-sized target at a certain distance. They say it's 2,850-yard human-sized detection range. But more importantly, how far can you look out and ID a coyote-sized animal or a hog? And I'm going to say a coyote-sized animal about 600 or 700 yards ID range. Now that is in good conditions. If it's foggy outside, that's going to be cut down a little bit because humidity and moisture in the air do degrade the picture image quite a bit, depending on how foggy it is at night. Display size is 1.03 inches, very large display screen. It's an AMOLED display, and it's 2560 by 2560 display resolution. A lot of resolution there, which works in conjunction with the ocular zoom. And again, a very important feature that we're going to talk about here in a minute. The color palettes, it has white hot, black hot, red hot, color mode, crimson, viridian, violet. And I'm surprised that I was able to sound out and pronounce viridian with my East Texas education right there. It does have picture in picture display, Wi-Fi. The laser rangefinder on the H50R unit has a effective range of 1,300 yards. It does have a bullet drop compensator ability, so you can get in and set up bullet calculations to put a drop down reticle for whenever you're shooting long range and you need to be able to range it and have some bullet compilation with your shot. It does have video and audio recording. The internal battery, you'll get about 3.5 hours of runtime on the internal battery, about 2 hours of runtime on the removable battery. So there's two batteries that work in conjunction with each other. And the removable battery is an 18650, very common, very inexpensive battery. The weight on it, 49 ounces, that's with the mount and the batteries installed in it. It's got a temperature weather rating of -4 degrees up to 122 degrees Fahrenheit. Recoil rated for 300 Win Mag and 7 Mag. And it does have a 5-year, 5-business-day repair or replace guarantee through IRAY USA. So Nocpix, this brand was introduced by IRAY USA at the beginning or end of last year, 2024. Very popular, really, from day one. And it's because of some of these features that we're going to mention right now and talk about in the advantages, because it's very clear and very pointed as far as why these are so popular. So let's talk about something very important before we move on. I've already hinted at it a couple times as ocular magnification and digital magnification and the importance of that key feature in the Nocpix scopes and the reason why it's so popular really in just a short amount of time when it was introduced at the end of last year. So this scope does have ocular magnification, and I'll describe that a little bit. So typically, a thermal scope has digital magnification. So digital magnification, the scope is actually magnifying the thermal sensor. Well, every time you do that, every time you double your magnification, you're removing half of your pixels, which is degrading your image quite a bit. So this scope, the advantage for this scope, it has ocular magnification where it is magnifying or zooming in on the display. So you're actually doing your magnification up here instead of down here digitally. Now, the reason why the Nocpix works so well is because of that 2560 by 2560 display screen, and it's, you know, a little over an inch in size. And that key figure, that key feature of the high resolution and it zooming in on that keeps the image together very, very well. So you can go from 3 power to 9 power ocularly, which that's a mouthful to say, but you can go, 3 to 9 power ocularly and still keep a very clean image on the display, make that coyote or that hog or whatever you're hunting a lot bigger on your screen, which allows you to take a better, more precise shot, but you're not losing the picture quality that you do with digital magnification. Now, it does have digital magnification that you can use in conjunction with ocular. So it's got 3 to 24 digital, it's got 3 to 9 ocular, but in most cases, probably aren't going to need more than 9 power when you're out hunting at night, since most night hunting is really done mostly under 300 yards and most of the time under 200 yards. So ocular magnification, a key feature to this scope that gives it a big advantage over the competition in that price range. Let's talk about some more advantages for the H50 and the H50R. Not only, like I said, it does have ocular magnification on both models, the H50 and H50R, H50R does have the built-in laser rangefinder. Now, the laser rangefinder module is inside the objective lens. No more having an add-on, removable laser rangefinder or one that's hanging off the side. This being in the lens does give this a more sleek and stylish design. It keeps it out of the way, and it does perform very, very well. It does, the 1,300 yards, I was able to range out to close to 1,000 yards, which is finding an area in this part of the world can be tough, but the laser rangefinder does work very well. The bullet calculator works very well. Love the fact, that these optics do come, both models, H50 and H50R, do come with a return to zero quick release mount. Now this is the mount that it comes with. This is the L35. I have it in the standard Nocpix QD mount. Works very well. It's a double throw lever locking QD mount. You could take it on and off. It does return to zero. I've taken these, this L35, the S60R, I've taken these off rifles many, many times, returned them, gone out and hunted with them, and they've been spot on. No problems with that mount at all. I do have the H50R in the American Defense Manufacturing mount. If you want a name brand mount, this one works in conjunction, works perfect with this scope. So the ADM Recon mount, that Outdoor Legacy that we also sell, you can get that too. That works with it, but does come with the QD mount. That's a big deal. The bullet calculator compensation ability, that is attractive to a lot of people out there. There's some that's like, I don't really care about that. But more and more people are asking about laser rangefinders and bullet compensation. So you can put your information in and it will adjust your point of impact based on the yardage of the target that you're ranging. Pretty easy to set up. I get a lot of guys that say, I don't like technology, or I'm intimidated by technology. And they are able to get this scope and be able to get it set up. Now, the good thing about buying your optic from Outdoor Legacy is that you can contact us directly if you have questions about this. And, you know, we'll help you out. We'll help you set up your scope and your bullet calculator, and just making sure that you're getting the full experience of the optic. That's another advantage of working with Outdoor Legacy. So rechargeable batteries, really like the fact that it does come with a removable 18650 battery option. So just to show you real quick, this turret on the side is where you charge it. You can turn this and it kind of opens up a little door in there where you can plug in your USB-C. That's how you charge the internal battery. This door over on this side, it's got a little button there that releases the removable 18650 battery. So it's got a battery on the inside that you charge. It's got a removable 18650 battery that you can take out. It comes with two batteries, and those batteries are very easy to find, very inexpensive. On the top, you have this is your main control turret. This is what you're going to be using a lot to get into the main menu or make some quick adjustments on the fly, but it's your menu button on top, and also a turn turret right here. It does have your buttons here on the top with your power, your laser rangefinder, your video recording button. A lot of people are like, I don't want a scope that records video, or I don't need that. All of these scopes now are going to include video and audio recording. It's a feature that they all are just going to come with. It's like trying to find a truck that has the regular roll-up windows, you know, with the handle. You just can't find them anymore. But because it has all of these features, it does seem like a lot, but you don't have to use all the components of what this does. You don't have to use Wi-Fi. You don't have to use the video and audio recording. If you just want a fantastic scope that's going to perform well, these are a very good option. It does come with a rubber eye cup too, rubber eyepiece, if you want to put that on there. I usually set up these tube style scopes without it, but we want to get to really the only disadvantage. I would say the runtime on this, with 3 hours internally, 2.5 hours, on the external battery, you're going to get about 5 to 6 hours of runtime. That's not the greatest on the market. It's not the worst, but it's not the greatest. So I would say, as far as the negatives, that's really the only big negative I found. And I wouldn't say that it's even a big negative, but the batteries, would last a good long time. No problems there. You know, being able to go out and get a lot of hunting in, get back in and be able to get up in the morning and go do it again. So batteries situation, again, the only small negative being that the runtime on the batteries is not the longest. Okay, the H50, the H50R, who it's good for, this is an important part of the review. This is what people are like, hey, I'm trying to find a scope. I need to know if this is gonna work for me. First of all, it's a 3-power base magnification. That's gonna be ideal for somebody whose average shooting distance is gonna be 100 yards and further, or somebody in general that likes a little bit higher base magnification. If you are hunting in the woods and a lot of thick stuff and a lot of brush and a lot of cover, 3-power scope is probably not what you're gonna wanna go with. You're gonna want a wider field of view with a lower base magnification. But if you're a predator hunter, a coyote hunter, most coyote hunters do want a 3-power scope. If you're somebody that's hunting over a feeder and you generally like just a little bit more base magnification, a 3-power scope will do just fine. This does give you the ability to shoot very well and very accurately long range because of that ocular magnification, being able to go from 3-power to 9-power ocularly and not lose that much resolution. I was able to take some really long shots that normally I don't feel comfortable taking because of ocular magnification. So coyote hunters, predator hunters, hog hunters, I'll tell you, when I first started doing this 10 years ago, I liked a 1.5 power scope. I'm a little bit older now, 10 years older, and hate to admit it, but now, I mean, 90% of my shots are 75 yards and under because of what we're doing down here in East Texas. But I prefer a 3-power scope, and I think that it gives me just a nice full image, makes those tight shots a little bit easier. So 3-power is definitely for the market, the popular starting base magnification. So that's really roughly who it's good for. Again, the important thing here though is I don't expect you to just look at a review or pull up this review online and be like, okay, I made my decision, that's my scope. Now you might have a good idea and you might think, hey, this is a good option, but you need to take this into account with all of the other, you know, the Nocpix models out there, or maybe you're looking at some other brands. You want to know, hey, is this the right thing for me? The best way to do that is kind of what you're doing right now. You're watching videos, you're kind of narrowing your search. But the next important step is to actually talk to people that have used these scopes. And I'm not talking about just going on a Facebook forum and saying, hey, what's the best scope? You need to, because you're going to get a lot of people on there that have used one scope and they're going to try to tell you that their scope is the best. But what you need to do is just call and talk to people, and you can call and talk to us and call and talk to me specifically. And we can tell you if this scope is right for you or maybe something else. You can do that at 877-350-1818, outdoorlegacy.com. The uniqueness about this channel, again, you can watch the reviews and you can talk to me directly. There are guys that call. I talk to dozens of guys every day, and this is my full-time job. I make videos at night. I create content. I create the Late Night Vision Show podcast. But 8 to 5, Monday through Friday, I am talking to you all day, every day, about what scope is right for you and what's going to fit your specific application. And it's a process. It's a decision process. And you do that by having conversations with people that have used a full gamut of different types of scopes from the early days of the earliest ones on the market to now. And with me and Jason Robertson at Outdoor Legacy, we have many, many years of testing experience, of many years of in the field experience with these optics. So you can use our vast knowledge and help you make your decision. And we hope at the end of the day that you choose to do business with Outdoor Legacy, because that's what continues this channel on, as well as the Late Night Vision Show podcast, which is a weekly show that is done every Thursday on YouTube. You can watch that. And we also review all of these optics as well. So thank you for watching. This has been the H50 and H50R review. We talked a little bit about the S60R, the L35. Those reviews are coming soon, along with hunting videos. If you want to see hunts with the H50R, I posted that video last Thursday, just a few days ago. You can go back on my YouTube channel and see all the fun hunts that I had to do, you know, had a chance to go and do with these, with some hog hunts, with some coyote hunts. And at the end of the day, thank y'all. Thank you for allowing me to do this fantastic job and to get to serve you. And I appreciate that. It's the biggest blessing of my life. And I would love to talk to you if you're interested in purchasing a scope. We will see y'all very soon.